Carry, as we lovingly called him. He joined back in 1967. He taught mathematics and chemistry. He retired in 94 and continued to teach even after that. As Carl just told me, 2017 was his 50th year in the field of educating and enlightening the minds of the world. I, for one, represent the class of 1991. And for the 10 years that I spent here on 32 Bridge Road, Mr. Karanjia was one of the pillars of this institution. It was we called it the mathematical chemistry triumvirate of Gomes, Narona, and the inimitable Nash Karanjia. I mean, to us, they were almost like, you know, these superheroes, this legion of superheroes for whom no problem was unsolvable. And solving problems was Mr. Karanjia's forte, as you remember. He was a no-nonsense lover of mathematics. He was a true gentleman's gentleman, as Apu just said. The act of teaching was everything to him. I mean, he saw it every time he walked into a classroom. And the students that followed his instruction well, they knew this. He knew the exact decimal where he left off in the previous class and would walk into class and start writing on that blackboard as if there was no break between classes. His handwriting and penmanship, I mean, it's the stuff of legends. I mean, even today I have all my certificates and merits that I've collected over the years. And most of them are written in beautiful cursive handwriting by Mr. Karanjia. And I should cherish those forever. You know, there's actually a font online called Cami. Seriously, I mean, check it out online. It's probably been trademarked by someone. It's a lovely cursive font. Mr. Karanjia was fair to those who deserved it, a disciplinarian when he needed to be, and he had absolutely no time for those unruly backbenchers. He would say, "Pandemonium in the backbenches." And we laugh and giggle because, you know, we heard our seniors say that he says this, and so we waited for him to say it. The doors are open. Get out if you're not interested. Classic line. And we laugh more and rile him even more. And if we got him to that point where, you know, he couldn't take it anymore, that chalk would come flying at us, perfectly aimed, hurtling, hitting us squarely on the top of our head. And that's when we knew he had enough. You know, to those that did get his question, the answers to his questions wrong, he'd say, "Look, you either know mathematics or you don't know mathematics. It's very simple, plastic rascal. Practice, practice, practice. What else is there?" And he was kind. You know, he took time to carefully correct our answer sheets during every exam. His multicolored pens, you know, blue and green and red. And if we ever made a mistake in a formula or an equation or we miscalculated an angle, he would take the time to actually point out the positives in our answer rather than just mark a big red X. You know, one vivid memory I have of Mr. Karanjia is outside the classroom. As students here, we never wanted to walk down four flights of stairs ever in this building, I remember. The easiest thing to do was to hold the handrail and either slide down the handrail or jump from the top step to the bottom step. There's not a single student or ex-student in this room who hasn't done that or remembers doing that. I, for one, was a jumper. I jumped from the top to the bottom. It was very efficient. One day, I came hurtling down the steps, turned around a flight of stairs, I think second or third floor, and I was in midair when I suddenly realized Mr. Karanjia was walking down the stairs in front of me. I don't know what happened, but somehow managed to avoid him, fell on the ground in a crumpled heap. Gary helped pick me up from there, looked at me squarely, and said, "Karachiwala, your fate is sealed. Your days are numbered." That was Nirvana. Because I made Mr. Karanjia say, "Your fate is sealed." I never forget that. And of course, I don't think I ever misused the staircase ever again. A teacher affects eternity. You can never tell when his influence stops. This is a quote by Henry Brooks Adams, and it applies so well to Mr. Karanjia. If we all have teachers that we all look up to who made a difference, who really inspired us, I know for me, Mr. Karanjia was that teacher to me. And I'm sure for a lot of you sitting here today. Our deepest sympathy to Carl, to your mom, and your family. May God bless you and help you through this trying time. And to Mr. Karanjia, who I'm sure is listening to us right now with that, you know, that wicked smile in the corner of his mouth. From all the thousands of young men that you've inspired, sir, simply thank you.